In this video, I'm going to show you how you can create a user manual according to the 82079 standard to comply with European requirements. Just follow the 5 steps that I'll explain in this video. In step 1, we're going to identify the directives. I want you to go to this website, instructive.com/en/CE-marking, where you will find an overview of all possible applicable CE directives that may apply to your product. Mark any directive that may apply to your product. If the directive or regulation really applies, will be determined next. Then, go to this website of the European Commission, where you can find and open the directives or regulations that you've just marked. Of each directive or regulation, consult the scope, exclusions, which are part of the scope, and definitions to determine if the directive or regulation really applies to your product. Download and save all directives or regulations that apply. Next, create a spreadsheet and add the directive or regulation names to the first column of the spreadsheet. In step 2, we're going to identify the vertical standards. I want you to go to the same page of the European Commission. Click on the product groups that apply to your product. There, you'll find a link called Publications in the Official Journal and summary list of titles and references of harmonized standards. Click on these links to open the file and select any standard that may apply to your product. Verify if the standard contains requirements on the instructions for use. Most normalization institutes have published a table of contents online. Check if the table of contents contains a section called Instructions for Use or Instructions or Marking and Instructions. If so, purchase the standard. Add the standard names to the first column of the spreadsheet. In step 3, we're going to determine the relevant requirements. Open the directives or regulations that you've saved. Press Ctrl F and search for instructions. For standards, go to the chapter Marking and Instructions or Instructions. Add relevant requirements to the second column of the spreadsheet. In step 4, we're going to determine the horizontal standards. Besides the vertical standards that we've just determined and say something about a specific product group, horizontal standards apply to a broad range of products. The most important one is the 82079 standard on information for use. This standard contains almost all guidelines to create your user manual and gives requirements on the content, presentation, and structure. Optionally, you can also purchase the ISO 3864 standard on safety symbols or the NZ535.6 on safety messages. Add these standard names to the first column of the spreadsheet. Add any relevant requirements to the second column of the spreadsheet. This is how your spreadsheet may look like. In step 5, we're going to draw up your instructions. As you've just determined everything that must be in your user instructions, now you can start creating them. This is where the actual technical writing comes in. If you want to save time and money, you can also purchase one of our templates. Our templates contain all legally required components to create user manuals for your product. Just click on the link below this video to visit our web store. What does our template include? It includes elements to comply with the 82079 standard on information for use. It contains all elements to comply with the Radio Equipment Directive, Low Voltage Directive, and EMC Directive. It contains text to comply with Wii, Battery, and Packaging Directive. It contains elements to comply with NZ535.6 and ISO 3864. We also have templates specifically for machinery and medical devices. We offer a 14-day, no reason required guarantee, and you'll get a full refund if you're not satisfied with our template. Additionally, you'll get a CE marking checklist, an A2079 checklist, an ebook on how to create compliant instructions, and an InDesign template. Just click on the link below this video to visit our web store.